Now, we will discuss about speed and velocity. First, we will discuss about speed. Speed can be stated in two ways. First is general speed. Second is initial speed or speed. Whenever we say speed, it is always initial speed. How average speed can be defined? Average speed is always equal to total distance covered by the body divided by time interval, that is time taken. So whenever average speed is to be defined, time interval need to be defined. Because in different time intervals, average speed of a body may be different. Let's see. Average speed can be written like this, either like this or V average or V bar. And what is average speed? Average speed is equal to the distance covered by a body divided by time taken. The notations used for writing average speed are like this, V average, or like this, or like this. And what is average speed? Average speed is equal to distance covered by a body divided by time interval, that is time taken. Whenever average speed is to be defined, time interval need to be defined simultaneously. Because in different time interval, average speed of a body may be different. The average speed indicates what? It indicates the overall fastness of a body. Average speed indicates what? It indicates overall fastness of a body, because during defining average speed, that time is also taken into consideration in which body do not move, but body remains separate. Mathematically, we can say, suppose this is a distance time graph for a moving body. The distance time graph for a moving body can be of any shape. One vertical shape of distance time graph for a moving body, suppose like this. Let's assume distance covered by a body in time t initial is s initial, and distance covered by a body in time t final in S final. What I told you earlier, whenever average speed is to be defined, time interval need to be defined. We are here defining average speed between T initial and T final. What I told you, distance covered by body in time T initial is S initial, and distance covered by body in time T final is S final. So distance covered by body between T initial and T final is what? That is S final, not S initial. So average speed is what between T initial and T final? Average speed between T initial and T final is S final minus S initial divided by T final minus T initial. That is equal to delta S upon delta T. If you look at graph, we can say this is the initial position, this is the final position. Join these 2 points like this. Suppose this angle is theta. So this angle will also be theta. What is this? This is S final minus S initial. This we can write like this, delta S. This we can write like delta S. And this is T final minus T initial. This we can write delta T. So this average speed between T initial and T final can be written as 10 theta. What is 10 theta here? 10 theta is slope of chord of distance time curve between given time limit. Slope of chord of distance time curve between given time limit, that is here T initial and T final. This is average speed. Since speed is a scalar quantity, it is always positive. So average speed is always positive.